supernatural. Goddamn. You know what time it is. You got the Sit Down Zumock podcast in full effect, coming live and direct right here in Ohio, doing the intro. You know this is. Has been baller, the Z man, king of stupid, the Lawson's chip dip consumer, Chad Zumock. Want to congratulate the Cleveland Cavaliers on going to the finals. Unbelievable game. I was shocked that they pulled that one out. I had everything against them. Boston, they had not lost at home. Cavs were playing without Kevin Love. It just looked like it was over, and they pulled it out. It was unbelievable. Had a great night. Watched the Cavs win. We went to Dave Chappelle's joke joint, or what's it called? Something. He had a big party at a barn in Xenia, Ohio. But we went out there, got to see Dougie Fresh, all kinds of great musicians. It was so much fun. So I'm a little banged up. I'm hurting. You can go to my Patreon, the $3 club. You know what's going on, the $3 Gunners. You can hear about my story about meeting Chappelle, hanging out with him at his house. Really cool. Bonus episode. I'm throwing all kinds of bonus stuff. Everything going on to Patreon. $3 Gunner, $3 a month. You know what's up. Oh, speaking of Dayton, Ohio, I'm going to be at Wiley's June 1st and 2nd. Three shows headlining. If you know anyone in the Dayton, Ohio area, I'm talking Liberty, I'm talking Columbus, I'm talking Springfield, I'm talking Yellow Springs, I'm talking Cincinnati, anywhere in the area, tell them to come through, see the Z-Man. Very affordable ticket at $10. And if you're on Patreon, you get in for free. You just send me a message. I take care of the Patreon. That's a cool. If you go to the Patreon page, there's all kinds of rewards of things you can get. I know some people had just signed up. I'll give you guys a shout out real quick. But yeah, check that out. Wiley's, June 1st and 2nd. Come see the Z-Man. Holler at your boy. All right, this week's episode's with Godfrey. He's been on this podcast a bunch of times. You know I know Godfrey. You know I love Godfrey. One of my main men. Takes care of me, takes me on the road. Had me open for him at the Village Underground Comedy Cellar. Just a good dude. We start talking pop culture. We start talking 80s TV, 80s theme songs. We talk a little comedy. We do it all. When Godfrey gets on the mic, we just go. We act like children. So I think you'll enjoy this episode. Give it a listen. Give it a review over on iTunes. Drop 4 stars, 5 stars on this bitch. Make it work. Share it. Oh, and if you're on Spotify, hit subscribe. Follow me on Spotify. Okay, guys, let's get at it. Holla.
Sit down, Zumock.
Sit down, Zumock.
I've got at least one pair of good shoes in the back of the closet somewhere.
I'm an American. I am. I come from a family with a proud, strong American tradition. My grandfather served in World War II. My dad served in Vietnam. And I served at Applebee's, so. Bunch of bullshit.
Hit me! Sit down, Zumock.
Pass the mic.
You get us over?
Let you get on. We're going to pass the mic back.
Yeah.
It's back to Mike, back and forth. We're going to pass it back and forth. All right.
John from Denver.
Denver.
John Denver.
Oh, God. Ugh. I don't think that was his real name.
You don't think that was his real name?
I think he had a different name. Because I saw the Behind the Music on John Denver.
You watched the Behind the Music on John Denver?
Dude, I watched the Behind the Music on all the fucking classic guys. But John Denver was dumb. He like had made his own airplane and crashed in it. Dumbass.
Get Rocky a plane Mountain that High.
They were made by somebody else. Get a company plane, stupid.
I like that country bit you were doing about Waylon Jennings and...
Oh,
yeah.
There's, you know, you see all those fucking, the
Talking to your microphone.
You see, because you know why? First of all, I love that music.
Yeah.
And I know that music. And my parents had it in our houses. We had Everly Brothers, for Christ's sake. But it's good music. And when you do it, and I do it right, what are they going to say? They go, this motherfucker knows these songs. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I love when I do my country music because I have knowledge about country music. Because country music is just white people blues.
Yeah.
All it is. It's just telling story. It's derived from black blues. That's all it is. And country music guys were very, very parallel to black blues singers. I mean, are you serious? Can't you tell?
Right.
But it's funny how it was so segregated as far as the type of music it was. And it's always associated with like racism and rednecks and shit like that. But country music, I mean, honestly, is there some good shit? Good songs are good songs. Ray Charles did country music. Ray Charles, Lionel Richie, are you serious? Yeah. Did country music, man. Country music is inverted white blues, man. And telling you, it's just the opposite side of white, like, you know, poverty. And you know, and it's all suffering.
I love how you said music sucks across the board, though. Rock, rap, country.
I forgot to do my rap shit, but I did the rock. I did that because I love to do the Mick Jagger thing.
Right.
70 years old, doing his thing, still sticking it.
Yeah.
But music stinks on all levels, man.
Across the board. Rock, rap.
Hip hop. It's like, oof. I never knew black dudes would get corny.
Right now, we are Guns N' Roses is cashing the fuck in. They have not recorded a new album since.
Why are they cashing in?
Because the nostalgia, they're back together with Slash and Duff.
What?
They're back together.
They apologize to each other?
Oh, yeah. It was the biggest thing. Now they're selling out arenas. They re-released.
First of all, they don't have to make any other music.
No.
Good to go. AC/DC, that's the one thing I love about AC/DC. They sing the same songs and pack stadiums.
Same riff, too.
Same riff. And that dude can still sing that what's the Scottish guy?
He's out of the band, Brian Johnson.
The lead guy?
Axl Rose was filling in. They did a tour with Axl Rose.
And so he can sing like that. I think Jim Brewer needs to be the new fill-in.
He could.
Jim Brewer should literally do it.
He could sing.
And you know he would. Jim Brewer, I think, should do a couple of shows.
You know what else? With Jim Brewer, he wants to do that. He really does. He tried to do like some weird heavy metal thing.
Yeah, I remember.
But it's almost like a porn guy trying to act. Like, like that dude's in porn, dude. The same with Jim Brewer. That dude's a comedian, man.
Yeah,
like,
but I think it would be for shits and giggles would be dope if Jim Brewer could try doing it.
He can hit those notes, though.
Yeah. So we're talking to who's next to me?
John.
Well, you got to introduce him on your thing, right?
John, introduce yourself to the world.
Yeah.
I like to give the introduction to the world.
I just came in to get out of the rain. no, my name is John Nova Sad.
Sad or sad?
Sad, like Nova Sad, like a sad Chevy Nova.
It's like new sad. Nova Sad. Nova means new.
Oh,
sad.
Yeah. And then I have a friend who's a server at one of the comedy clubs. She calls me John Never Sad.
So. Well, yeah, I've never seen you. You've never been sad. You're always pretty mellow. Just mellow, like things are okay with you, man.
Yeah.
You look
things
like
are okay.
There's no trouble here, man. You're just doing your thing, man. You're happy to be working. You look like you appreciate work.
I do. I like doing comedy. I still really like doing the shows. And so
it's
to get a week in Dayton.
Good for you, man.
John, do you have any influence with Ian Will Phillips?
Do I? He has influence on me. Oh. No.
Meet him?
I did, and I actually opened for him once. And
wow, was he a nice guy?
Yeah, and it was in Boulder, Colorado, which is my hometown. So it was at this theater called the Boulder Theater.
Yeah,
it's like 900 seats, 1,000 seats.
Yeah,
I'm opening for Emo. They have a guy from the radio station introduce me.
Ugh.
I go out and it was weird. But I do like 15 or 20, and then the guy from the radio station is going to introduce Emo, and Emo's backstage, and he goes, "Why don't you introduce me?" And points to me. So I'm like, "All right." And I went back out,
awesome.
You know, and said, "Hey, it's me again, you guys. I'm going to bring up your headliner." And I brought him up. So
that's awesome. He said, "I don't want that radio guy."
That was
he could be like, "How you guys feeling? All right. We got another."
Right after the traffic.
My favorite Emo Phillips joke. I worked with him in Erie, PA. Yeah. Here it is. You ready? Yeah. I once got in trouble for not opening the car door for a lady. Instead, I just swam to the top.
Oh, that's funny.
That's good.
That's hilarious.
When I opened for him, he did this thing about, how about a riddle here? And he would get the crowd like going, yeah. And then he would go into other material and he'd go, how about a riddle here? And he would get them all so worked up for a riddle. And then he finally did the riddle and he goes, what's the difference between a bowl of chili and a urologist? And he goes, one is hot and spicy and the other checks urine specimens. And that was the whole riddle, man.
Wow. Emo.
I already was. Is he from Chicago? I don't know where he's from. Yeah. Where is he from?
I'm
I don't
not
know.
Sure.
Emo Phillips. Know. Emo Williams or Emo?
Emo Phillips.
Emo Phillips. Yeah. I remember that Bob haircut. He still had the Bob.
Yeah.
And he still goes, that weird.
He's got a really unique delivery.
Unique
for
delivery.
Sure.
Yes. Here she is. Yeah, man. This day, the thing about, like, this is my first time at the Funny Bone, Dayton.
Sure.
Funny Bone. I don't do a lot of. I mean, I do Cleveland, Ohio.
You don't do a lot of comedy clubs.
Shut up. I do Cleveland, Ohio. I do that every year, you know. Now it's Dayton, but I haven't done Columbus, which everybody says is amazing. And I would love to be on that Ohio State campus. Check
the
that
home
out.
Of Dave Shroop.
David Shroop. I'm trying to find that guy. He's like a myth.
I know. Have
legend.
You met Dave?
I've never met Dave Shroop.
Dave's a good dude. You'll like him.
You know what I mean?
You'll
so
meet him.
Cool. Because I know. I want to make sure I'm in his good graces. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Because you never know nowadays, you know, with any. There's so many club owners, so many managers. There's so many There's so much ranking in comedy club ownership and that you don't know who you piss off from the lowest person. I'm not saying low as in putting them down, but just ranking-wise. You can say the wrong thing to a waitress who might be the cousin of the general manager who's the regional manager of the 18 Chuckle Huts.
Sure.
And then now you're screwed.
Come on through.
You
know we're good.
I mean? So you never – that's why you got to be careful. That's why I try to dot all my I's and cross all my T's, and I try to make sure, hey, did I disrespect anybody? Is everybody all right? You know, so
– you've been around for a long time, so
– I've been around for a long time, man. I think it's like – and that's funny because I think – when you've been doing headlining for like 10, 12, 15 years, that's when you're like in your prime.
Right.
Like, because headlining is also an art form too, man. People think that shit is easy. A lot of comics that keep going out early, a lot of these comics that are getting shows easy, they're getting deals with YouTube, they go on the road and they see the reality hits them dead smack in the face. And Ohio, a place like Ohio is a good place for an arrogant motherfucker.
Just to get humbled?
Oh, man. Especially these blue-collar working motherfuckers that ain't got time for that bullshit.
Right.
And they're working hard, and they're like, man, I pay my money. They're counting every dime. They're like, yo, you better – man, I better be rolling off this bitch. And I love when these arrogant little bitch comics come with their fucking YouTube deal, and they come and they get a nice – as Keith Robinson would say, a nice hot shovel to the chin. I love when that happens, man. You know what I mean? It's like, yeah. So, I mean, and it's not about wishing bad ill on anybody, but it's just the approach to this thing, to the art form is so arrogant. I go, man, I don't know how, because this shit is so hard. And even if me as a headliner, man, I know I'm going to say I'm going to be funny, but I still got to strategize sometimes. You go, okay, I got this crowd shit. Man, let me see what I'll bring. Okay, I'll do that. Oh, okay. You still got to strategize and stick and move and then catch him in a pocket. Ah, got him. Ha, ha, ha. Good night. Shit.
Before the show, I've worked with you for a long time. It was the first time I ever seen you take notes. You wrote down notes.
I just wrote down notes because I thought I was like, oh, let me see if I want to remember a couple things to throw out there.
Right.
Because sometimes when you just totally forget when you're in a zone.
Yeah.
Because my last set, I didn't know where I was going with that one. It was just a good organic, boom, boom.
Right.
You know, it was more like a stick and move. Especially with crowds that are really like, and I'm being dreary, like kind of humdrum crowds. You got to kind of stick and move. You got to kind of, not a game plan, but you got to kind of be ready to be on your feet and throw something at them. You know what I mean? That's what's important. So
there it is.
I was just going to say, sometimes you just got to keep going. That's for sure, yeah. You know? It's like we were talking about earlier, man. There were some people that were really chatty. They were having a birthday and stuff. And I made the decision not to talk to them because they were not heckling me directly. Yeah. And so I get that. But also I wanted to say, like, there's a difference between doing 45 and headlining a show. You know what I mean? There's a lot of people that can do 45. But it took me a while to figure out how to close a show the way I work. But, I mean, I did it, you know?
Yeah, that's cool.
And that's...
You know, I work with you in Denver, but, like, doing the comedy works, like, it's... That's a different animal. They're there for comedy, man.
That's, like, the one of the best rooms in the country, it's, for sure. You're spoiled. That downtown club is,
You're literally spoiled doing that club.
And, I mean, it's the called the Comedy Works. It's in downtown Denver. It's like, yeah.
I do Denver. What's funny is I do Denver Improv, and they're rivals, kind of, I guess. But I want to do that club because it's famous. It's like when I got a chance to actually work at, I do it like in San Francisco, I do Cobb's, but Punchline is the most famous. So I go, at least, you know, Molly let me go up and do some, I got to go up there. It's a legendary room. You know, it's like being a baseball player not playing at Wrigley Field. I want to play at Wrigley Field someday.
That's a great analogy.
You know what I mean? Shit, I want to play in those legendary places, and I still want to do the Comedy Works. And even though I love Denver Improv, they show me love. And any place that shows me love, I show them love.
Shout out Amy King.
Amy. Amy King. So that's, yeah, man.
Every time I get Godfrey on the mic, I don't want to talk about comedy. I talk about comedy.
Forget the comedy. Yeah, it's too much.
Fuck the comedy. When I get Godfrey, I can go to any area in the world. But I always just love talking old school television with you. So when you were bringing up, like, Dukes of Hazzard.
Yes.
You and your brother watched Dukes of Hazzard?
Damn right we watched Dukes of Hazzard because we like fast cars. And Tom Wopat and John Schneider were the hillbilly version of Starsky and Hutch.
Well, if you think about it.
They dark hair. It was dark haired and blonde haired guys.
Yeah, you had Starsky and Hutch. Starsky. You had Tom Wopat.
And John Luke. Schneider. Yeah.
What other combos? Cagney and Lacey.
Cagney and Lacey, dark haired, blonde haired. It was like those were the black and whites of the day.
Yeah. And Riptide, you had Joe Perry.
Riptide, there was Simon and Simon.
Simon and Simon.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry, Simon and Simon. I never really watched it, but that theme song was tight. Then it starts going. Hardcastle McCormick. That wasn't very long. It didn't last that long, but it was pretty cool.
They had the car. Everything was like a black hair, blonde hair.
Right, black hair, blonde hair. Fast car. It was always a fast car.
Yeah.
Cop shit. Heart to Heart. That was my shit. Robert Wagner.
This is Mrs. Hart. She was gorgeous.
And when they met, it was murder. I mean, there was all of those. There was all those great shows, man. The theme songs were great. The scores were great. Douglas S. Kramer and what's her name's dad, Tori Spelling, Aaron Spelling. They made some good shit.
The Spellings were killing it in the 80s.
Starsky and Hutch, Beretta. First of all, Beretta's one of the greatest.
Don't go to bed with a price on your head.
No. Don't do it. Don't do the crime if you can't do the time. Yeah. Don't do it. So keep your eye on the sparrow. Dude, you sing like shit. Jesus. Sorry. You hear that? You hear the music?
You're jamming to Simon and Simon.
How about the Fall Guy? How great was that song? I'm not the kind to kiss and tell, but I've been seen with Farrah. I've never been in anything less than a 9. So fine, I've gotten blown up with Cheryl T. Oh, man. And he was singing it. Lee Majors. Like, come on, get it. Find it.
Yeah, somebody was like, hey, Lee. You're starring in this. We gotta. Where's Alan Thicke? I'll do the fucking theme song.
And Lee Majors is Texas. He's like, I can sing it. Yeah, man. He's like, I can do it. He's like, I've never spent much time in school, but I've taught ludus plenty. It's true, I have my body out for pay. Hey, hey.
And he came off the fucking $6 million man.
Man, the $6 million man. Gentlemen, we have the technology.
Yeah.
We can rebuild him. Steve Austin, a man barely alive. Gentlemen, we have the technology. We can make him stronger, faster. Here we go. Farrah, I've never been with anything less than a nine. So fine. I've been on fire with Sherry Field and a girl named Bo. And somehow they don't end up as mine. It's very so fine when I find these. I take my chances.
I'm a fall guy.
Movies and TV. Hold on. But the hardest thing I ever do is watch my leading ladies. And friends. Landers remind me. Here we go. I look from a tall building. A brand new car. Cause I'm the unknown stunt man that makes Eastwood such a star. That makes Redford. Redford such a star. Eastwood is later. Here we go. He's going to start snapping. Never spent much time in school, but I've taught ladies plenty. It's true, I got my body out for play. Hey, hey, I've been on the spin over Cheryl Teagues and up and Raquel Welch, yeah. It's only hey, 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 I can jump an open drawbridge or Tarzan from a vine. But I'm the unknown stunt man that makes Eastwood look so fine. That's my shit, yo. I'm a TV baby, boy. Fuck all of y'all.
The same way. I'm like, I grew up on the TV.
I grew up on
the TV. In the same era. Like, I was a TV. Mm-hmm. Yeah, I was a kid. That was my shit.
That's right.
Those theme songs meant something. Mm-hmm. These theme songs today with TV and the net. Like, who? Okay, sing this theme song to Walking Dead and Breaking Bad. You can't.
Breaking Bad. Sing it.
Breaking Bad. Man, it's bad. And it's fucking breaking.
Breaking Bad. I said it's Breaking Bad. I'm so, so sad with no facade. When you're Breaking Bad, Breaking Bad. I said Breaking Bad, Breaking Bad, Breaking Bad.
Don't make
I'm broken. I'm broken. With chemicals and shit. Yeah, he gotta quit, man. He was a teacher one time. He said, fuck this shit. I'm making money, baby. Let me get a little white boy to help me out. Aaron Paul, bitch. What? Breaking Bad. I said it's Breaking Bad. Things are looking real sad. Breaking Bad. Yeah.
That's the real theme song. They just always show the instrumental.
Lyrics. What? It's like Bonanza. That had lyrics, too.
That's Bonanza. Hey, Hoss.
I see you last weekend.
Oh, yo. It's Ice-T, man. I know everybody. Hey, I'm going to go check on the bodies and the subjects. You know what I'm saying? When I was spitting, motherfuckers don't understand.
You know what he said to me?
What did he say?
I go, because we're talking, and because he likes metal. He loves metal.
Mm-hmm.
And we're talking about Florentine, so I got that ultimate in. Mm-hmm. And I go, how's your TV show doing? He goes, oh, man, we've been on longer than Gunsmoke. And it's true. I Googled it. He's right. That TV show, whatever, NCI or whatever.
SVU.
SVU.
Law and Order has been on.
Longer than Gunsmoke.
Longer than The Simpsons.
Yeah.
Damn.
I mean, talking about a guy who's...
You know what's scary? Is Law and Order has been on long enough when Homer Simpson was actually young. Cartoons age. And you know Homer's like, I remember back in the day when Law and Order just started. Now I'm old and fat.
Is The Simpsons still on?
Hell yeah. Yeah!
Fuck, I don't even watch it. I mean,
it's on so much. It's like Lucille Ball. Every once in a while, you'll catch a couple episodes. It's always on.
But
oh, they are? Wow, man. What about South Park? Is that still on?
I'm not sure.
Is it? South Park is still on, I think.
Jesus Christ.
I don't know why they'd go with this Trump around.
Tripoli was telling me about there's a new cartoon called
Big Mouth, Nick Kroll shit?
No, it's something and something. Somebody and something.
Oh, Rick and Morty.
Rick and Morty.
They say it's supposed to be amazing.
Yeah, he says it's the shit.
I say it's so good. I haven't seen it yet. Have you seen the BoJack Horseman shit?
I heard of that.
BoJack Horseman?
Even like Bill Burr's cartoon, which it's hilarious.
F for Family?
I just want to like invest myself in a cartoon. I'm like, I'm out.
You're out?
Yeah.
How can I? What makes Bob's Burgers so great? I don't get it.
I don't watch it.
You really don't get it.
Dude, I was out of cartoons. Like, tonight on stage, you were doing the Fat Albert song.
Hey, hey, hey.
I know. Like, that was my era. Like, I'm waking up, Sunday morning cartoons, Looney Tunes,
right.
Tom and Jerry.
Right.
So, like, the cartoons, they don't resonate with me now. Like, The Simpsons was probably the last one, like, when I was younger, when Bart had T-shirts that say, Aya Carumba. That was my fucking era. But even with... South Park, I'm out.
When I first watched The Simpsons, I was like, and they remember they made a big deal out of Bart Simpson?
It was huge.
And when I watched, I said, nah, Homer's the funny one. God damn it.
Yeah.
I said, Homer is the funniest one on there. And then Homer became the lead guy. I go, Homer is way funnier than him. I said, first of all, Homer looks crazy. And the shit in his voice, making dope. Oh, I said, God damn, that shit is funny. Bart and Homer can fight, though. Too. Homer's violent as shit.
In the beginning, Bart was the shit.
I'm saying, remember they do the Bart man and all that?
Yeah.
And then when I watched some of The Simpsons, I said, oh, I'm sorry, but Homer is the funniest one. I'm sorry, man. Homer is hilarious. That Flanders.
I just wanted to say a couple things really quickly.
Say whatever you want, John.
Our research assistant checked, and South Park is getting ready to start its 21st season. So that's pretty wild.
Holy shit.
And here's the other thing, though. I wanted to talk about The Simpsons because my favorite Simpsons ever was they were in Duffland, and Bart and Lisa.
In Duffland?
Yeah, they're in Duffland, and Bart and Lisa are on this boat. And Bart goes, hey, Lisa.
Right.
I dare you to drink the black water, because it was like the water was like all funky in this ride. And so she drinks a handful of it, and she trips out. And then she's like tripping real hard, and she's covered in a blanket later, and she goes, I am the lizard queen. So now back to our regular programming.
Oh, I like that we're eating on mics. Oh, it's so great.
Podcast is great.
You don't have no manners. It's great.
There's no HR. There's no management.
None of that.
No one's going to come down like, dude, you can't eat.
I don't know. Well, we've been hanging with Dave.
Go ahead. I talked about this on my Patreon about we hung out with Chappelle.
Chappelle's been...
We went to his house.
Went to his house. I didn't even realize. I forgot that he lived over here in Dayton, Ohio. He called me, and I saw a phone call from Chappelle, and I thought he butt-dialed me. I was like, what the fuck did he call me for? And I didn't realize, because his sister came to my first show, or the second show, and I didn't realize that he lived over here. I forgot. And he was like, hey, Godfrey, I'm here. When's your last show finish? I'm going to come over there. Maybe visit. Who knows? I'm thinking about it. You know what I mean?
Are we going right now?
Is that cool? Yeah. Damn! Huh? Damn!
Damn!
All
right.
Yeah, we're doing a podcast right now.
Going on the credits. No, all right, no. Can we do a to be continued sort of situation?
Yeah, let's do a to be continued.
All right, we're going to take a commercial break. We'll be right back after these commercial messages.
Word.
By the way, check out my Patreon. You can sign up for additional bonus
Patreon,
episodes.
That's what that is. I was listening to that. Patreon.
That's where I'm at.
They have to subscribe and pay, right?
Go to patreon.com/sitdownzumock. $3 a month, $3. That's change in your pocket. You can listen to additional Patreon episodes, bonus episodes. But I have to go to work right now. So enjoy this commercial.
Word.
You and your other friends.
Spider-Man.
Can you tell us who is who?
The Flash.
Is Superman on the left?
Underoos look out of sight.
Superman!
All of us were all good guys.
The Hulk! You can pick your favorite if you try.
Yes, you can! Underwear is fun to wear. It's true when it's you and your underoos.
Wow, now there's the Dukes from the Dukes of Hazzard.
Bo, Luke, and General Lee, it's true, are all on your underoos.
And we're back. I actually put a commercial in there.
Did you?
Not yet, but I will.
Oh, you're sponsored by something?
No, I put like fake commercials like from the 80s in, like Kangaroo City or...
No way.
Do you remember the old store, like...
Which one?
Stores.
Stores? What do you mean? Like Woolworth or something?
Yeah, Woolworth, like Woolworth, something like that. Gold Circle. You remember Gold Circle?
It depends on where you grew up.
You're from Chicago.
I had Goldblatt's. We had, we had Florsheim.
Yeah.
All these were Jewish stores.
They were all department stores, too, right?
They were all Jewish merchants, man.
Yeah.
Goldblatt's.
Goldblatt's is Jewish.
Florsheim.
Yeah.
Goldblatt's. There was, Macy's is still around. There was, Woolworth.
Did you have Red Barn in Chicago?
Red Barn? I don't think so, nah.
Red Barn was the big chicken joint in Ohio.
Nah, we had Church's Chicken.
Well, Church is still around, isn't
Church's
it?
Church's some. There's some. That's good chicken, though. That's good shit.
Yeah.
Church's, of course, probably, but Church's Chicken was my shit. It was good
Mr.
stuff.
Chicken's still around. Mr. Chicken's still tight.
Mr. Chicken.
No, you don't feel it?
Mr. Chicken. No, I don't have Mr. Chicken. We have Harold's Chicken in Chicago. We had Harold's. We still got it, but Harold's Chicken's a big chain of black chicken places.
What about Arthur Treacher's, the seafood?
Arthur Treacher.
You remember that?
Long John Silver's, too.
Well, Long John Silver's still in the mix. Around.
Still in the mix. They kind of came back.
Well, Long John, they were smart. They paired up with, like, was like other, like, shitty restaurants that were going down.
Yeah.
They made, like, a combination.
Combination combo. Smart.
Yeah, it was like Little Caesars and John and Long John Silver's.
Little Caesars used to say, Little Caesars, bam, bam.
Pizza, pizza.
Pizza, pizza. No, it used to go pizza, pizza, bam, bam. But it just goes pizza, pizza. It's weird. I don't know.
Do you remember Avoid the Noid from Domino's?
Oh, remember that?
That was huge. I had like a t-shirt.
I remember when the guy.
The toy.
I remember when a guy dressed up as the Noid and came into the Comedy Cellar and sat in a chair.
He dressed up as Avoid the Noid?
Stayed in his Noid suit. And I was like, I literally avoided the Noid. I'm not going to. It's too easy. I'm not going to fight. That's why they kind of stopped doing Halloween shows, because people would come in
dressed up
crazy, and it was just like, it would just disturb the whole show. It was too much.
Oh, I did New Year's at the Cleveland Improv, and they gave everyone noisemakers.
Oh,
and I go, what are you doing?
When?
It's like 5 years ago.
They did it while you were on stage.
Yeah, the whole time they're blowing into their fucking whistles. I go, what are we doing? And you get paid double because it's New Year's, but at the same time, you're going through hell. Comedy clubs are retarded.
What?
They're retarded. They do dumb things like dress up and the bachelorette. Like, they do everything. Yeah.
It's silly.
Yeah, they think of everything but the show itself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah. I don't know why. They just think comedy. Hey, man, you're up there. Just do whatever.
Yeah, just go up there.
The element should always be on your side. Even though you can't control the elements all the time, but everything you can control, you have to make it advantageous to the comedian.
Right.
Make sure the mic is good. Make sure it's loud enough where you can overcome the crowd in case they get mouthy with you.
Make sure there's lights.
Make sure there's lighting. Make sure the stage lighting is good. Make sure the shit stage is safe. Give us an advantage, man. What the fuck?
Like on Thursday night when the girl threw the glass at you on stage? Like,
girl threw a glass at me on stage, folks. She threw it to my side. She didn't hit me with it.
But still, like, that should not happen.
Yeah, and she got mad over nothing.
Yeah.
Nothing. I just asked her. I just talked about Colin Kaepernick. She got mad. She said he's disrespecting the armed forces. First of all, he's not. So, and I asked her, hey, could you explain? She goes, fuck you, and then throws a glass. And I'm glad that it didn't hit me, because I think I would have probably tried to hit, like, bust a head open with the glass.
Sure.
I'm glad it didn't hit me, because a natural reaction would be like, well, bitch, fuck you, you know?
Right.
But she threw it, and I just kept calm, and I joked on it. They dragged her
out. Said the course.
Her family yelled at her, which was great. So me not reacting helped me win that fight. Thank God. It was fighting without fighting.
Yeah, you were doing the Miyagi.
I was doing the Bruce Lee.
Miyagi, too.
What's your style?
fighting without fighting.
Yeah.
Fighting without fighting.
Fighting without fighting.
Fighting without fighting. Fighting without fighting. Before fighting without fighting.
Before we took the commercial break, we were talking about going to Dave Chappelle's house here in Dayton.
Yeah.
Who have you known since 1996?
Yes. I've known Chappelle since 96, man. It's a long time.
No, it's so surreal because, you know, regardless of what we do in this, we've met everybody. I know you've met everybody with SiriusXM 126 and everything.
Yes.
But you still get a little like, okay, this is Dave Chappelle. This guy's, quote unquote, done it all.
Yes.
In this business, and it's never lost upon me.
Right.
So, I mean, with you knowing the guy for so long, you're still like, oh, okay, this is Dave. He's
right.
Still the man.
He's the man, but, you know. He's a man, but there's like, I've been in it long enough where I feel I'm the man too. Fuck that.
I know. I mean,
but I know what you mean.
Yeah.
I know what you mean.
You know, like, yeah. Like even like a guy like Kreischer, who, you know, he's above me in this business. I'm so like, oh fuck, Kreischer, he's killing it, man. That's my guy. You know, I'm happy for him.
Yeah, man. It's weird. It's like ranking and rank and file in this biz, man.
It's comedy. Comedy's high school, dog.
Yeah. You got your cliques. You know, you got some people who have better grades than you. Some people who are better athletes than you. You might be better than them and that. Clique is shit, man.
I think I was talking about on my podcast. I go hanging out with you and... Because at one point, I shut the fuck up. I just listened as you guys did a personal podcast for me. It was almost like... In high school, I was talking to the quarterback and the prom king. They were just hanging out. The high school quarterback.
High school quarterback.
Yeah.
Yo, there's Bob, man. There's Jim McCannon, man. Dude's dope.
Those guys are the shit, man.
He's a varsity quarterback.
He's awesome, man. He's
quarterback for the Dragons. He's great.
I heard he just signed for like a Division III school.
Yeah, man. A full ride, man. He said he might give him a try to USC, man. Yeah, man. That's pretty good. That dude's amazing, man. He's a beast.
I mean, he's a beast, man.
That guy's a beast.
The guy knows what he's doing.
He's a beast. He can throw like the whole field. Beast. He has a cannon. He's a beast. Guy's a beast. That's what we do. We do our white dude. Yeah. Gotta have gains all day.
Gains, dog.
Gains, man. Gains.
Dude, you gotta get your gains. You gotta lift. You gotta eat your protein.
You gotta
lift,
get your gains. Gotta get your sleep. Gotta get your rest. Gotta get your stretches. Water. Gotta get your cardio in there. Water all day.
Water is the most important thing you can
gallon,
do.
About a gallon and a half gallon, 2 gallons.
Drink 2 gallons.
2 gallons, 2 gallons.
Eat 75 pieces of protein.
75 pieces. 900
chicken.
Definitely chicken. About 200 grams protein all day.
You gotta do 15 lunges. 15,000 lunges.
Carb cycle. Like to rotate.
Yeah, rotate. Good carbs. Eat good brown carbs. Rice. Brown rice.
Brown rice all day.
Yeah, brown rice purple is good. Those are good carbs.
Purple rice too, but it depends. It depends. It's all cans. That's how you get the body. That's how you get that 300 body, man.
Those are all Eddie F's friends. Everyone we just did. Yeah, he's a big CrossFit dude.
They're all like that.
They're all like douchebags. They just it's like a total cult. They just talk about working out nonstop. Right. And you work out. I've worked out with you, but it's just like we're not obsessive over
like
it.
Like that. It's like, yeah, dude, seriously, man, got to make sure it's slow burn.
Slow burn.
Especially on those deadlifts.
Less weight, high reps.
Less weight, high reps. Especially on it's all about technique, and it's all about depending on your perpendicular. But your knees got to be perpendicular. You got to be definitely parallel thigh, parallel thigh, ass to the grass, ass to the grass all day, man.
Ass to the grass,
you know, thighs to the sky. Bro, no, seriously, that's what we say in CrossFit country.
Have you ever done CrossFit?
Fuck no. My knees are sucking. My ankle is all fucked up. You know what I mean?
I don't know why we do that. You're basically fucking up everything. Jumping up, pulling yourself up.
Yeah.
Going crazy. I don't understand it, man.
Yeah, it's like if you have good joints and all that, so be it. All that force on your joints, man.
Whew. Do you take like fish oil or any kind of supplements?
Some supplements I take. You know what I mean? Depends. I got my buddy's protein powder. They're pretty dope. I use.
You're getting gains.
I'm getting gains all day.
You got your gains.
I got my gains. One body part a day. Make sure you hit 5 or 6 different exercises. 12 reps, 4 sets. Sometimes I do a supplemental set. Depends on how busy the gym is. Hopkins.
You can hear Godfrey on Sirius XM 126 Monday through Friday.
Monday through Friday,
the Power Hour. God damn. 12
to 1 Easter time.
How many people are coming out to your shows?
Shows have been good, man. This one show now.
It's like a little. It's a little half tap.
Memorial Day weekend.
You know what I mean? I mean, we packed them the past shows. I'm not mad.
Absolutely.
Thursday, Friday, the two shows Friday, Saturday. So it's been like four in a row. Four.
On Memorial Day weekend, this is a fucking money.
I can't believe it. Like, but this Saturday last show is a little weaker than all the other ones. But I'm for my first time. Yay.
Yay. New market. Yay. You're back in business,
new
dog.
New market. You know.
No, but people listen to Godfrey on Sirius XM 126. Follow him, Comedian Godfrey on
Comedian
Instagram.
Comedian Godfrey all day.
Which is a great follow because you do little videos. You're always doing like sketches, and it's always if you're on Instagram, follow a guy like Godfrey because he does like fun things. So
racial, some celebrity shit. One guy just asked me like, "Why is it always about race?" It was like a brown dude said, "Why is it always about race? We should just move on." I said, "No." I told him, "Here's the deal." I said, "When police brutality, denigrating of black women, poisoning of black children, fucking up infrastructure in black schools and brown people's schools, when all of that stops, I will stop doing racial jokes.
Plus, it's fun."
Right. And so obviously, I'm going to continue doing it. And Trump apologizes for shit. Then I'll stop. I'll stop doing racial jokes. It's like, move on. First of all, you know what? I'm being honest. The hatred of black people is an old idea. So obviously, the powers that be are not moving on because they still are shitting on us. So moving on, we've moved on. Black people have moved on. We try to move on. You know what it's called? We escaped slavery. That was moving the fuck on. You know, hatred of black, racism is an old idea. So why don't the other people move on?
See, I
white people need to move on. Because if you still hate black people, you're not moving on because it's an old idea.
Well, can I talk on behalf of myself? I'm not trying to
be real.
No, but like I don't know if it's because I'm in comedy, I've seen too much, you know, my mom having black boyfriends. I just don't see it. Maybe I'm just oblivious to it. The racism. I just don't see it. I don't know if it's because who I surround myself with.
Because you're white.
But,
hey, I just don't see the police brutality, bro. I just don't understand.
But there's a lot of shit going on out there with a lot of people. Like,
yeah,
it's
but
to me,
you're a white male. Like, honestly, you're a white male. I'm just saying it is what it is. You can literally, you're a guy of good intention. You get along with everybody.
Sure.
But you can literally walk through somewhere and no one's staring at you crazy. No one's following you in a store doing.
And I'm not.
Like,
yeah.
You feel me?
Yeah.
For
yeah.
Me, I have to be aware sometimes because I'm like, oh shit, they're watching me. This, that. Because when a black male, especially, walks into a room, the dynamic changes a bit. Especially if there's other white men, because they're always intimidated by us, our presence. I don't know why. They just always have been, and you know what I'm talking about. They just always have been. Like, there's always been like a thing.
But do you think in comedy it's different? Because I think in comedy, I swear to God, you're a comedian. That's what I see. I see that guy's a comic.
Right.
Comedian.
No, right. But still.
It's the greatest equalizer.
If we weren't in entertainment.
Sports and entertainment are the.
If we weren't in that and we were just regular guys, engineers or whatever, regular dudes, would you see us differently?
I'm not the guy to ask. Outlook is completely
different.
Yeah.
Right. But other than that, outside of that, there's guys that are like me that are just regular dudes. They're cooks. They're truck drivers. And they go through shit.
Sure.
A lot more. You know, because they're not doing the typical entertainment and all that other shit.
Maybe I'm oblivious to that. I don't know.
If I was white, I'd be the same way. I'd be kind of like oblivious. If my people were in charge and I looked white, I would be kind of like, oh, what are you talking about?
Well, I think Chuck D, who's been on your radio show and my podcast, said it best. He goes,
"Yeah,
you need a passport, and you need to go see the world, and then racism disappears once you go see the world. Like, there's so much more out there than America."
So true.
Yeah.
It is real. Racism, I don't know if it disappears. It's around.
Yeah.
Still, even overseas, but, you know.
At the end of the day, an asshole will always be an asshole, regardless of the skin, color, preference, or whatever.
Yeah.
And you can go to other countries, and I think it's looked upon differently than America because of the history. I really do believe that.
Right.
I think the history here in this country, it's what it is.
Yeah, but racism is an old idea from Europe, European domination. And all people, whites in America, are just transfers from Europe. That's it. That's all.
Yeah.
And, you know, and they brought that here and they caused havoc here.
Yeah.
And I'm not saying they, you know, I don't mean you specifically because you're smarter than that. But, you know, it's back and forth. It's worldwide. Africans are treated like shit. Moroccans are treated like shit overseas. So I've been around in those countries where you talk to those people and the racism is still there.
Right.
So for Europeans to go, wow, but the racism is different over there. It's like, why don't you put some sprinkles on a pile of shit then? It's the same thing. Our racism is different. Dude, it's still racism.
So the answer is the movie The Blind Side. You need to take a take in a black guy from the hood and make him good.
You ever watch The Blind Side with no volume? Ugh.
I call it Harry and the Hendersons. That's funny.
That's funny, though. That's hilarious.
All right, Godfrey, I know we got to go on stage real quick. This is a good podcast.
Good podcast.
Follow Godfrey, everybody.
Comedian Godfrey.
SiriusXM. It's a wrap.
It's a wrap.
Was chasing your direction, I was telling you.